Okay, so welcome back, guys. I had a small work at my house, so I had to leave early. Now only the last part of motions are left. Okay, so we'll quickly go through the motions. And so in a normal MUN, just for information, there are motions to move into a moderated caucus. There are motions to open the general speakers list. But in this case, we do not have such motions because, like I said, we are in the start. From the starting only into a moderated caucus. So, okay, now if I shall share the screen because it is a bit important to read the procedure alongside. So, I think you all can see my screen. So, we have different types of motion. Now, there are two types of debate. So once suppose delegate of North Korea presents their clause, and then I will be opening the floor for people to speak against or for the motion for the clause as a whole, right? There will be I will accepting the amendments as well. So during that time, that is known as a open debate, but we can move into a closed debate as well. So, what is a closed debate? Now, in a closed debate, we have speakers for the clause going first or for the amendment going first, and we have speakers against the amendment going second. Right. So, that is known as a closed debate. But what generally is we are in order is that we are in a open form of debate. So we can move into a closed form of debate. So that is when a delegate will raise a motion to move into closed form of debate. Now in a closed form of debate, you will be able to speak two speakers for and two speakers against, or three speakers for and three speakers against. So that is how we move into a closed and open debate. So once the debate is over, the motion lapses. So what basically motions are? Motions is how you move from one part of the debate to the other. Generally, I will be directing the debate in the direction. But other option is you, the delegates, can raise a motion as you wish, right? So all of these motions will have to be passed with a simple majority. So we have 14 delegates. So the simple majority stands at 50% plus 1, which will be 8 delegates. So 8 delegates will have to vote in favor of a motion for it to pass. If we have 14 delegates. Next, we move into a motion to move into time against. Right. So once we have moved from open into close, then only this motion can be raised. So for example, we are speaking for, but there is no one who is willing to speak for. In that case, we all can move. So Chehak wants me to explain the closed debate once again. I'll explain it. So motion to move into time again. So like I said, in the closed debate, I will be accepting speakers which are for the motion and speakers which are against the motion. Now, you cannot raise this motion. Suppose, for example, if I recognize India and Australia to speak for the motion. So after India finishes their speech, the delegate of China cannot raise the motion to move into time against, because I have recognized delegate of Australia as well. So that motion will fail by the discretion of the chair. That will not be put to vote. But however, even if after Australia, I feel there is time and I would like to ask to prevent more speakers from speaking in the for, the delegate can directly raise a motion to move into time against. If there are no for speakers, I will only direct to move into time again. So this motion will seldom be used. This motion will not be used quite frequently. Then I think I will tell you. Yes, adjourn the debate, it's not much. Motion to extend the debate time. So like I said, I will be inviting delegate of North Korea to explain their clause. So I will set a debate time, for example, 15 minutes. Now, when that debate time elapses, the delegate, any delegate can raise a motion to extend the debate time. So, for example, if I said 15 minutes and that 15 minutes gets over, but you had an amendment in your mind and you had sent it. So in that case, you may raise a motion to extend the debate time, and that motion will also be put to vote once it has the chair's approval. So in that case, the debate time will be extended. The next I would like to say is debate to move the previous question. So this motion is like you can rephrase this motion into motion to go to the next step. So move the previous question. It is not move to the previous question. So what previous question is what we were doing earlier. So for example, if we were discussing the clause of North Korea, and that at that moment, what we will do is if anyone raises a motion to move the previous question, all the people who if I have recognized anyone, this motion will not be able to sustain. But if no one is recognized to speak next, the delegate of suppose let's say China raises a motion to move the previous question, I will suspend the debate and directly move into the voting. If two things: one, there was no recognized speaker; second, the debate is still going on and no delegate is speaking. So all of these motions cannot be raised when anyone is speaking or any if anyone is recognized. This can only be used when no one is speaking and no one is recognized. So for example, if North Korea give their speech and there is no point of information for them, the delegate of China might raise a motion to directly move into the voting. Now that motion will also be put to vote. So you need 50 plus one majority in that as well. So none of the motions can be passed directly. Next, we have motion to move into unmoderated caucus. I think that has been discussed. So unmoderated caucus is that I will not be supervising you all. You all can have a chat with your allies and enemies as well. Next, we have motion to adjourn that. Okay, so we will not have motion to adjourn the debate because we just have a conference for one day. I think this motion will stand suspended, motion to adjourn the debate. Right, so two important motions right here. So motion to extend points of information. Now let's look at a scenario. For example, delegate of Qatar, let's assume that they are here. So delegate of Qatar, or let's say delegate of France. So delegate of France describes their clause. Now after the delegate of France describes their clause, I will ask, is the delegate open to point of information? And the delegate says, yes, I am open to 5 points of information. So if I recognize only three people, because only three delegates raised their hand, now there is 2 points of information still remaining. Now, after the three delegates who are recognized finish their points of information, I would have generally asked the delegate of France to go back to his seat or to lower his hand in a Zoom meeting, right? But if someone else, for example, India, who was not recognized earlier, may raise a motion to extend the points of information, and again, this motion will be put to test. However, there are put to vote. However, there are two limitations or two exceptions where this motion cannot be used. For example, if delegate of France who was explaining the clause or even the amendment says that he is open to 2 points of information and two people have been recognized earlier, then the delegate of India cannot say that a motion to extend the points of information because the delegate of France limited their motion, their number of points of information. So then the by force I cannot extend the points of information. Similarly, the second time this motion will not be in order, that is, the motion will not be accepted, is when the delegate says that he was open to any and all points of information. Then I might not allow delegates to put this motion into order. However, it will depend. If we have time, I might put this motion to test. Okay, I think the motion part is only this. Yeah, motion to divide the house. Now, suppose if we have 15 delegates. Now, if suppose we have 5 delegates voting for, five delegates against and five delegates abstained. So what happens that this the amendment or even the voting for the clause will fail. This clause will not pass because 50 plus 1 vote was not there. In Thymoon procedure, we have 50 plus 1 for all types of voting. So we didn't have 50 plus 1 vote, the resolution will fail. However, just because there were 5 for and 5 against, the motion to divide the house can be raised. Now, motion to divide the house is like a motion to take a vote by roll call. So if this motion passes, every delegate in the house who is present will have to necessarily say for or against if this motion passes. And the only time I will allow this motion to be in order is when there is a chance that if the abstain go for, the motion will pass. Let's assume one more example. If we have 10 delegates, only 2 voted for, 7 voted against, and one abstained, right? So in that case, I will not put this motion to order. I will not even consider voting for this motion, because even if the one abstained goes into voting for, we will have 3 for and 7 against. So this will not allow the motion, this will not allow the clause or the amendment to pass. So there is no use of putting this motion to test. This motion will only be put to vote if there is a chance that those who abstained, if they vote for the resolution or the amendment passes. So these are the main motions which are there in the Thymoon process. So I think I will revise once again quickly. So what we have is, you will be submitting the clause to me on 31st July at midnight. So it will be 1st August in the morning at 12, you can consider 12:01 a.m. So you will send me the clauses and the position paper. The clauses will be segregated. Then the submitter of the clause will be called upon on the dais to speak on the clause as a whole. So he has to highlight the main points. Then the delegate will be asked if he is open to points of information. Points of information are questions. So after the delegate says that, okay, he's open to any and all points of information. So I will be recognizing delegates who wish to ask the delegate of, let's assume North Korea was presenting the clause. So delegate of North Korea will be questioned by delegates of, for example, China, France, India, Pakistan, all of those. Then if after the points of information are over, I will ask the delegate of North Korea to return to their seats. That means that the delegate of North Korea will be asked to mute their mics in this case. Then what will happen is I will now open the floor for general debate. So in this time, you may come on the dais and speak for or against the motion, the clause. Once you come up on the dais and speak for or against the clause as a whole, now you will again be asked after you finish your 90 second speech that whether you are open to points of information or not. So it's up to you if you want to recognize delegates asking you questions. After you have spoken for or against, if someone else had an amendment that was sent to the chair, the delegate can raise their placards when I ask them that are there any speakers who wish to speak on the clause as a whole. For example, delegate of Russia proposed an amendment. Delegate of Russia may raise their hands and ask, has the amendment suggested by delegate of Russia been received by the chair? If the answer to that question is yes, if I have received that amendment via WhatsApp chat, you will be called upon on the dais. That means you will have the floor. You will now present your amendment and then that amendment will be voted upon. Yeah, so once I recognize the amendment, the proposer of the amendment will be called. So this is it. Is it compulsory to send? Yes, Niyati, you might lose, not lose points, but you will not be able to gain points if you don't send the position paper. So, Niyati, is there any specific reason you don't wish to send a position paper? Or you are just asking just for the sake of it? Okay, so Shubhendu has said, do we have to send? Okay, so we only have to send operative clauses. So for the information of any everyone who is first timer, we generally have two types of clauses. We have the preambulatory clauses and we have the operative clauses. The preambulatory clauses generally don't have much of a weightage, generally speaking. So what we have usually is we only have the operative clauses. So, for example, yeah, here we have, this is a sample resolution. Now, resolution is something that we are not having. We are only having the clauses. So, in this case, you will only be sending this. These are the operative clauses or the operational clauses. And these are all the preambulatory clauses. So, preambulatory clauses is something similar to an introduction to the topic. For example, the question of globalization and interdependence. So that you may say that this many, there has been migrants, there has been refugees, there has been resolutions by the United Nations GA and all of that. And then you say what you want to do. So those, what you want to do is like the operative clauses, and what the current scenario is are the preambulatory clauses. Okay, so Amanat is asking amendment proposed. So look, the amendment can be proposed. Like you, if I hope you can see the screen. You can see the screen, right? The new screen. Okay, so like I said, so there is a clause. So for example, we had this clause at hand. Which is strongly urges the Myanmar government, and there were sub clauses to it. So in this specific clause, in a specific position, you need to say whether you want to add something, remove something, or you need to delete the whole clause. So the clauses can only be, the amendments can only be related to the text of the clause. Or for example, it is also possible, I am trying to reconnect this, not reconnecting. Okay, possible, I will download this. Do I have this? Can I type? Okay, so I cannot type in this as well. Right, so for example, let's assume this was the clause which we are discussing. So even you can suggest a addition of a clause D. A, B, C, D, and you can say the D clause will be call upon the calls upon or request the United States to help Bangladesh, something like that, because this was about Bangladesh. So you can add a clause as well. You can delete the clause. In a specific clause, you can add a word, even a phrase, but that has to be said very precisely. For example, if we consider this C, so you have to mention the amendment is after the word from Bangladesh to Myanmar, you wish to add or you wish to replace the phrase Bangladesh to Myanmar, and you want the phrase from Bangladesh to Myanmar, India and Nepal. So in that case, you have to write from Russia to EB amendment after the words, or you have to write instead of the words Bangladesh to Myanmar in the clause 2 bracket C, the words Bangladesh to Myanmar, comma India, comma Nepal be substituted. So that operative clause will now be put to discussion. So you can come on the stage, you can discuss why you want Nepal, why you want India. And then what we will have is we will ask you if you have any points of information. So you can open yourself to points of information. And after you speak And after your points of information that you are open to are answered, now I will ask that is anyone willing to speak on the amendment as a whole? So even the amendment as a whole will be discussed just like the clause was. So I hope I am making sense. Amanat, is it clear? And everyone else? Okay, so even the clause will be put to discussion, even the amendment will be put to discussion. Now, yes, amendment to an amendment will not be in order. You cannot have someone suggesting an amendment and to that amendment you send in an amendment. That is not allowed. So, a amendment to an amendment will not be taken into consideration. It will be straight away rejected. Yeah, Amanat, it asks, answers your questions, right? You're okay, great. Is Niyati back? I don't see Niyati here. Okay, yes. So it is not. So you may abstain from sending the position paper, but I do not see any reason why you not send the position paper, because position paper is something that would help the chair to decide how well you have researched, how well you align yourself. Have you understand the international relations of the country? Because, for example, India would not align with some countries, right? So you need to keep those in mind and you need to formulate the position paper in that sense. So there is no specific reason why you should not send a position paper, because that could affect your grading. Okay, guys, are there any more questions? You may unmute, you may type it out, you may send it on WhatsApp, anything is perfectly fine. I think the motions are clear. I think the points are also cleared. Yes, Chehek. Yes, motions, like I said, only the six motions maybe I discussed would be in order. All the rest of the motions will be suspended. So we will not have a motion to have a moderated caucus. So, the motion to adjourn debate will not be in order. All of the rest of the motions will be in order at discretion of the chair at that moment of time. I think that answers your question, Jack. We have a limited number of motions, not all of the motions. Shubhendu, yeah, I will explain the motion to move into previous question. Yeah, personal chits. So what is a personal chit? Could you elaborate? You may unmute yourself and speak. Shubhendu?
Yes, Chair. What about, suppose we choose to answer the delegate not during the point of information.
Yeah,
and
okay.
So how will you pass the answer via the EB?
Right. So I will send a few examples on the WhatsApp group only. Everything has to be, every chit has to be sent via the WhatsApp group only. So there, just a second, I'll be sending you something. This is just an example that we had. So this is how you send a chit. It will be, I send it in the WhatsApp group. You all can check there. So it is like, to China via EB from Mexico, and then you can write in your reply. So that is how chits will be there. So chits are of two types. There is a substantive chit and there is a point of information chit. So for example, if suppose delegate of China gave a speech and then you wish to ask questions, but because the China opened themselves only to three point of information, you were the fourth one, so you weren't recognized. So in that case, what you can do is you can send a point of information chit via the EB on the WhatsApp group in a similar format like I have just sent. So in case you are not recognized, in that case, you can send your chits via the WhatsApp group. Yes, Jack, we'll discuss the motion to move into previous question again. So, okay, I will share my screen. Okay, right. So this is all questions. Understand all of these as questions. So, for example, if the delegate was asked, suppose if the delegate has answered all of the POIs, the delegate will be asked to mute himself. Now, after, for example, the delegate have asked all the POIs, and before I say that the floor is open for debate, before I speak that, if you raise a motion to move the previous question, it is not move into the previous question, it is move the previous question. So now these all steps, which was the amendment step, the for and against step, everything will be skipped, and we will directly move into the voting procedure. So that way, steps will be skipped. However, like I said, this motion will not be allowed if I have recognized people who will be speaking. So in that case, this motion cannot be moved. I think that would clear your question. So yeah, it's a very interesting question. There is very rare that you would use the motion to move into previous question. As my experience last year, none of the delegates when I attended the Thai Moon conference had ever raised this motion. But just for the sake of, because it was there in the rules of procedure, I explained it. It is very rare that you would raise this motion. But if someone raises, they must know this. In a case that I think might happen is that, for example, if there are only 10 delegates that are present, and you know that 6 are your allies, and you don't want the delegate of India to speak. So in that case, you might raise this motion because you know that this motion will pass, and the delegate of India will not be allowed to speak against the clauses. And then directly we will move into the voting procedure, and then again the voting will happen. So in this is a very limited scenario that I can think of, that is you need to corner a delegate. But you need to understand that this motion has to first pass with a simple majority. So for us to move to the next question, to move directly into the voting. So this truly speaking has a very limited application. Okay, great, Chehek. Are there any more questions? You may unmute yourself if it's comfortable with you. You need not type your question. Okay, I think Shubh, Dev, Avichal, we do not have any more questions. I think we could end the meeting right now.
Yeah, okay. No issues.
Okay, so delegates, I hope you research well. There is a background guide that's available. I do not want you all to limit your research to the background guide. You need to read in depth about. So one of the things is people will be calling out your flaws as well, your country's flaws. Because when you question someone else, make sure that you have your flaws researched. So if one of your presidents or your prime minister had given a statement which was controversial, you need to be aware of that. So make sure you read those statements as well before you accuse other nations of, for example, not handling the virus well or not allowing funds or concealing information. So make sure you have your own things covered up. And yes, one thing I would like to stress upon here is English is the only way we'll be accepting the speeches. So you cannot speak in Hindi. That will not be allowed. So with this, I would like, Arshil, I think you can start your lobbying right now. There is no bar in lobbying. I think what I have seen is that everyone has introduced themselves. So I am sure everyone knows from which country that person is. So you may start lobbying right now, but there is one limitation I would like to tell you, that because you are making your clauses on your own, you do not have a co-sponsor or a co-author with you. So therefore, lobbying will have limited application here, but that should not stop you from lobbying. So I think you should lobby. You should discuss with other delegates, and you should form your allies, because we have limited number of delegates in the committee. So it will be very important if you form your allies correctly. But because there are no resolutions, lobbying will not have much of an effect. But yes, you should lobby. Yeah, so position paper, I will type it on the group. So position paper, it is on 31st July at 12:59 p.m. Which you can say is about 2 days before your main conference. Yeah, okay, yes, word limit. So keep your, so in the operative clauses, yes. So minimum number of operative clauses. Is 3. There is no maximum, but like I said, you need to keep in quality versus quantity. And maximum size of position paper is in Times New Roman font it is. Margins are normal margins. It is 1 page. And size of the font is 12. Okay, so this is the standard way we are accepting the position papers. So there is no word limit as such. If you have more paragraphs, you will have less number of words. So accordingly, you can arrange yours. But just 1 page, that will be it. Are there any other questions? Yeah, okay, Chehek. So I think Chehek, that will, you may ask the delegates, you may send in a WhatsApp message on the group, and that way you can ask other delegates to change their country's name. That is not an issue, but I will leave that up to you to convince others to change their names. Okay. I think with this, we finish